Circus started very organically with a group of friends.
It's their childhood dream is manifesting itself in the present moment.
People are so conditioned in watching movies that they all think it's fake. There's real life on the line in what Nitro does.
To get to a live tour and actually pull it off, it is insanity. It was not possible.
These guys will never make it.
Nitro is about trying to find where it's not possible to go. And then going there.
Childhood never ended for this lively band of brothers. They've always had one mission: to have more fun than anyone on the planet. The crew is led by two good old boys who met when they were 12 years old. Jeremy Rawle, a hippie lawyer who gave up his failing law practice to fight off the symptoms of midlife crisis.
Am I done, or do I need to do that
again? You're done.
And Godfrey, the son of a trucker and the poster child for adult attention deficit disorder. Under Gregg and Jeremy's unorthodox direction, the crew recorded their adventures in a series of short movies and even a TV show. Through some creative financing, they made this movie, shot in 3D, which cost a buttload. They pitched their idea to Hollywood, but Hollywood crapped its pants. The studio executives were terrified that this movie was too dangerous. Pussies. The end goal for the Nitro Circus, the dream they've shared since childhood, was to perform their stunts live in front of an audience. They set their sights on a show at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas. But would anyone really come to see them? I mean, who are these guys anyway? I'll tell you who. First off, there's Travis Pastrana, the modern-day Evel Knievel, 18-time X Games medalist and 5-time national champion. But he can't throw a ball to save his own life. He's the All-American Wonder Kid and ringleader of the Nitro Circus. Then there's a 26-year-old man-child. Street Bike Tommy. He is the most adorable member of the Nitro Circus and the Fats. He loves cheeseburgers, soda pop, and hates his everyday occupation of hanging drywall. But the Nitro Circus is more than just fat, hairy men. Jolene Van Vue. She is tough, sexy, and downright full of it. She is the only one with a vagina. She keeps the boys in line by not just competing with them, but showing them up. Nitro Girl is the real deal. Not quite as sexy, but just as ballsy, is Eric Rohner, extreme skier and base jumper. He has no business on anything with a motor. Although he's completely out of his element with this group, he's always game to hurl his body into harm's way. For a dude with a tramp stamp, he's one bad mofo.
Come on, Special! No. Come on, hit him, Special! Come on, work it low, work it high, come on!
Which brings us to Special Gregg. Travis's cousin. He's a jack of all trades and master of none. Like a cat, he always seems to land on his feet. And like a nasty honey badger, nothing can stop him.
Well, all right now. That's what I'm talking about.
At least one member of the crew has a steady job, for now. Jim DeCham. He's Travis's oldest friend. He has a super long neck and is somehow able to always cheat death. He's the current world record holder for consecutive one-handed claps. These guys don't give a rip about what most people think is possible. They only care about pushing each other beyond their comfort level, giving it hell, and seeing if they can come out all right on the other end. They've been doing this since childhood. This is the Nitro Circus. So we might as well pack 7 people into a school bus and see how far that puppy can fly.
Teacher was right, and I was meant to be a bus driver.
Hands down, one of the coolest things I've ever gotten to do in my life.
Their biggest goal is to share what they do live in front of a packed house at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas.
We came from Mexico to see the show. We are really, really excited.
I've definitely never seen anything like it before.
Those guys are crazy with talent.
This is the best day of my life. Rock and roll.
I think the reason that people connect to Nitro Circus, it's I think everyone has a relationship to fear. I think you can all sort of harken back to that moment where you did something very stupid and somehow like just skinned under the wire of death.
It's almost like that idea of like if you had the balls or were willing to do it, it would be so much fun to get with all your friends and go do sketchy things and give you this amazing adrenaline rush.
It's crazy. Half the these guys do, they have to go out of the states because it's illegal to jump off buildings the way they're doing it. It's illegal to do the stuff they want to do in America. It's illegal, guys. That should be your, that's what it should be like. Oh, this might not be a good idea. Travis's like, nope, let's get on a plane.
Wow. This is one of those stunts that, this is why we do what we do.
Well, we just got up to the top of this skyscraper. 63 stories high above Panama City. This is going to be a very interesting base jump. First of its kind ever. And we're not too sure exactly how it's going to go.
When you jump off that, that ground comes at you real fast. I'll tell you that much. You got about 4 seconds just to figure it out.
You're good.
What could possibly go wrong?
Well, for some reason, me and Crumb are the only ones down here on the ground. I think we're Team C.
Yeah.
Say Roner.
We want to see what's going to happen down here. So we got Roner perched on a blob, and there's two fat Elvis Evil Knievels jumping onto him, and he's going to shoot off a blob on top of the building. You know what happens is I get so nervous that I have to pee. I need to pee. Like, I just want to pee because I have to pee. I'm not even doing anything.
You should pee, man.
I think I'm going to pee.
Hey, Jer, you ready for this, baby? It's go time.
Almost 500 pounds up there, I think. Maybe even more. Of men meat.
How is it out there, Eric? Sucks!
We've been waiting our whole lives for this. We're damn good, too, man.
Apartment building real close.
Hi.
I think Roner deserves a group hug, but he's still with us.
Rubberneck, you sick puppy.
Can we be done with skyscraper blob drop? Do you see what just happened?
Tommy ejected, missed all the safety boxes, and slammed into the ground. If Tommy had bounced the other way, he would have blobbed himself right off the building, and that would have been the end of Tommy. Tommy, I got a couple cheeseburgers coming your way. Thank you for launching me over that building safely.
Outside of street bike Tommy, you guys are far superior athletes. We're more theatrical with our costumes and man-on-man contact. You guys have more things with motors in them, and we do more pranks.
I came from Jackass, and when I met the Nitro family, it felt very familiar to me. I get the dynamics of it right away.
It's like all the same inbred family.
Really, just always boiled down to the difference between Jackass and Nitro was our Jackass stunts are always designed to fail. Everyone accepts that. Nitro stunts, you have to succeed or you die.
Same mother, different daddies.
In this game of Freedom Flyers, the objective is for me to leave my mother's nest and fly with the help of bungee cord and a jelly donut inner tube, hit that there jump, launch in, and take out as many of my friends and as much of their home as possible. In other words, I'm a wrecking ball in the form of a bird.
So, Rubs, this is your speed test for this. We need to line up how you're going to jump and to see how fast you need to go. So, you're our guinea dive.
The water is 3 foot deep. You're going to be 20 feet in the air going 120 feet in distance. No problem.
Yeah, let's get you on that tube.
told me it was time for me to leave the mother's nest, I'm ready to go right back into that nest. I think that was the biggest DDT body slam I ever had. Oh, I don't know about this one. There's so much that could possibly go great here.
Great possibilities.
There's a lot of scenarios. The goal was Tommy. Now the goal is to take out Parks. Parks is the only one left on top. I still think Tommy should be it. All right, I'm ready to freedom fly.
Go get him, Roder. Good luck, buddy.
I've ever had. The thing about freedom is you can never stop fighting for it, so we're gonna try again. Flyers has been pretty damn rough until this point. Unfortunately, we didn't accomplish what I was trying to accomplish, which was take out my friends and their home. But I think we gotta do it again. Sucks for me, but I'm gonna try to have a positive attitude and try to catch some more air. All you people that want to be on Nitro Circus and come out and do this stuff, ooh, it's so much fun. As we found out, freedom ain't free of pain.
To fill an arena in Las Vegas is no easy task. Everyone tells them they can't do it. A loss in what they do is different than losing a game. You miss a field goal, you miss a field goal. You miss doing a double backflip, you die. And they approach every obstacle like that. Those are paying fans looking to be entertained. You just can't lose.
Travis's compound that he has in Maryland is a true testament to that he lives this life.
It's in such a beautiful setting, you know, like these lush trees all around, and it's just, yeah, the devil's playground, man. Death is everywhere. You can smell it in the air.
The only thing that is burnt in my brain from that dude's house is the first time I went there. We're going into the foam pit, and this random dude just comes around, and he's like, oh, Travis, can I flip? And Travis's like, yeah, flip. Just don't go right. And that's when the dude took the 110 off the side. He, like, smoked himself. And I saw that with my own eyes, and I was like, dude, don't go right. Burnt into my brain.
It's a little factory of bad ideas.
After all these years of talking about it, you finally built us a loop in your backyard.
And every single thing that we do, someone in our crew steps up, and Jolene has volunteered to step up first.
Thank you, all right. Yeah, so you came right out this morning and said you want to hit this first.
I'm coming in hot. Everyone's got to go first once, and I just go. We push me on the hill. I don't care.
All right, let's get up there and do this.
This is a way better loop.
Are you on your third loop? Hey, guys, Tommy's on his third loop.
I'm looking for a baker's dozen.
Loops are stupid. I don't know why we built one. I guess just to see all these people that's here that are such badasses. And Jolene gears up first. Crazy girl. Crazy. I
I have nothing but wonderful things to say about Jolene because I'm scared to death of her.
Being the only girl in that whole crew, it must be very difficult, and she pulls it off like a champ.
For someone who doesn't have balls, she has the biggest set.
It looks fun, though, Joe. You're in the hot seat, not me, but it does look fun.
My main concern is Amy.
I do have a word of advice. Do you want to hear it?
I think I want to vomit, so I think I want to go.
Okay, we're ready to go, but aim for the black line. That's my word of advice.
Just get in there and hit that thing!
Yeah, what's taking so long?
Hey, just stop talking!
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, go, Joe!
Okay.
This is gonna be cool.
Got it.
Because you'll die?
I mean, I don't know. I did a tricycle, you're doing a wheelchair. Big difference.
Oh, man. I need some wheelchair advice.
Yes, and unfortunately, you're the only one of your kind, so
I
sorry you don't get
myself.
Any advice.
You're a unicorn. You're the only one of your kind. Only the only difference between a unicorn and you is that you've been spotted.
Aaron Fotheringham, a.k.a. Wheels. He was born with spina bifida and can't walk. If you ask him, he's not in a wheelchair. He's just riding one. Makes the rest of the crew feel like pussies.
It's my house, and I'm scared to death to go around this loop. And Wheels is going to try on a wheelchair. And I am scared for him. Good luck, Wheels.
You'll have fun, dude.
Come on, buddy.
Let's get it.
Don't think. You are the toughest kid.
Oh my god.
Dude, that was like seriously the first time I've ever seen things that float.
Oh my god, Aaron, you're hit.
How are you conscious right now?
Dude, you hit so hard, I thought you were going to start walking.
Are you ready to leave this loop behind you?
I sure am. This thing broke my heart.
What are you doing with that? Oh, no, no.
You have always wanted to get some respect of somehow, some way, as a real athlete.
Yeah.
You're going to begin your freestyle motocross career today.
Awesome.
What are you going to do?
Oh, I don't know. Whatever comes natural.
Buckle it up.
Oh, boy.
Consider this tryouts for the Vegas show, so don't screw it up.
Support this. You know what I'm saying? Couldn't have been a finger.
Yeah. All right, guys. This is the tallest, steepest BMX ramp that we have.
Jim, you want to calculate this ramp for us?
Yeah, I was going to do my math calculations. I'm going no pedals, no brakes. I'm just going whatever how big the hill is.
I really think that's about right.
Nice knowing you, Jim.
Oh, he's going so fast.
Good grief.
Jim sort of needs a little more coaxing, especially if it's out of his comfort zone.
Dude, and he kind of gets guilted into like, yo, I can do it. I want to be, I can do it too. I can do it too. And then some catastrophic thing.
If you hit absolutely perfect, I think you have a 2% chance. Good luck. Two? But he's going really fast. Too fast.
I even thought I was going, my judgment these days is way off. I always think I gotta go faster.
He's a real wild card, and he gets great footage.
We're getting ready to jump the big wheel at way too fast for the speed.
Holy
What's a big wheel? Okay, it's a kid's toy.
They must be the best put together big wheels ever. Like, these guys are jumping them at least 100 feet on some of their craziest ones and landing no problem. Like, it doesn't make sense. I think the only way that I would be able to get the feeling is if I had to try to ride the trike, which I don't want to do, Travis, so off.
All right, guys, over the past 3 years, the most elusive trick that we have not been able to do is the double backflip on trikes. This has turned into a mission. We have a launch ramp. We have Mount Mulchmore. And today is the day that we beat this trick. All right, hands in. Nitro on three. One, two, three, Nitro!
I'm the guinea pig. I got the short straw. I know how that works.
We got a long day ahead of us. Let's get to work. Fire one!
No idea what to change, what someone special did, but can hope for the best.
Fire two!
Just gave them a glimpse of the great white buffalo.
Who's up next?
Hi, Mom. You proud of me?
I just got a calf cramp. Give me a second.
You got a calf cramp. You landed on your face and you got a calf cramp.
This has been an absolute bear of a trick. We've had all the top trike riders come out all to Maryland to do a double flip. Everybody has thrown down their best. Everybody's been concussed. Everyone's been hurt. Dusty's taking the hardest hits. And Dusty's going back up because he's the only one of us that's even close to doing this thing. So fingers crossed for him that he can ride out of this thing in eternal glory in Nitro. This one's really been a tough one.
I hope I just land this one so I can go in the pool.
Dusty Weigel. Dusty is a new recruit to the Nitro Circus. Fresh meat, as they say.
Yeah, boy.
He's dripping with talent, still naive enough to try anything the older members say. He'll definitely work in the live show.
This was the trick, the stunt, the fun day that we all wanted to have, and you conquered it, man.
Dude, hold me down and dress me up. Let's go out tonight.
Get so excited about being the world's first double on a big wheel when it's just you and your friends that do it. No one else in the world. You're claiming glory. This is the greatest day of our lives because it's like four of you have ever even tried to do it, and you're the only ones with these highly modified next-level big wheels. Okay, so it's yours to own forever because no one's ever going to do it.
right, Hubert, somebody's got to stick that landing. We built all that mulch. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking me and four-wheeler and extra ramp equals success.
Good luck, Nitro Circus. Representing.
Redneck power.
Hubert Rowland, everybody's favorite redneck. Straight from the backwoods of Tennessee. He's handy with anything from a wrench to a tractor. He builds the stunts for the rest of the crew and makes a mean batch of moonshine.
Here he comes.
Right now, the mulch pile is winning.
Yeah, it's kicking ass, and I don't care whose name you are. I'll be honest.
Don't try to straighten it. Just flip that, baby.
The fact that he stepped up to do this, I'm nervous for the guy.
Oh, here he comes.
Come in.
Get me on the floor. Get me on the ground.
Hubert, I'm so proud of you.
Is it out? Is it
hold
out?
On, hold yeah, on.
His shoulder's out.
Could we get a shoulder back in with a side of relish, please?
You know what?
It might not be it.
I don't think it is.
I'm sure his arm's not broken. His arm might be broken. Hubert, I think you're just shocked that you just were so amazing right there.
Another guy that has no business doing that type of stuff, and you just kicked his butt, buddy. Good job. All right, well, you hang out for a bit. We're going to go on to another stunt. You come join up with us later. Come on, boys. Girl. Look, performing live is it's live. There is no let's take two on that, you know, and especially doing what you guys do, there's definitely no take two.
I ain't feeling so good right now. All I need is 16,000 people out there. Yeah!
If you need to take two, that means someone probably got hurt.
Always told my boys, you gotta go like hell.
Gregg never went easy. He always had to push the envelope. If Scott jumped 100 feet, he had to jump 110. Maybe from that, they got more and more and more competitive.
So here's the deal. I am the present world record holder of the longest and highest semi-jump in the world. My older, fatter, unskilled brother believes that he shall be the world record holder after this day.
In 15 minutes, I will be.
It doesn't count unless you land on wheels.
No, good job, though. That was fun.
You got issues.
We're here at this beautiful lake. It's a glorious day. You got your Red Bull rocking.
They've got this amazing jump setup. We've got tons of astroglide.
By amazing jump setup, you mean scary ramp of death into water filled with rocks. Cool. Awesome. So
this is Nitro Circus. Yeah.
I've seen you land on a head from 30 feet up with a street bike on top of you.
Yeah, and that didn't work out too good.
Well, this has got to work out a lot better then. It's a win-win for you. You hang on, you go.
Why do you guys always say win-win when I always effing lose?
Godfrey, you've tried this out, like Jer's chopper out there. You've got it all modified.
Well, kind of. And I'll tell you, if he hits it hard, you're going for a ride. And I'm just telling you guys, you're going for a ride if he cranks on that throttle, sir.
Well, the guy said they wanted a little horsepower to pull the rope. So we brought in our friend, the Colonel, to give us a little help.
You think this is really what they asked for?
No.
You're good. Don't worry about it. It may possibly be the most redneck contraption we've come up with.
Crum, I'm about to give you 1,200 cc's of freedom.
Smacked his face dead on his butt.
Yeah.
The lip.
I knew
that. And then he, like, it was. He was still holding on and violently hugged himself lifelessly.
The two fuckers.
He was just. It didn't look real.
Wasn't enough lube. It was all dried out. I got serious burn marks down my whole entire chest. No, it was peeling off me, and I was like, I'm not letting go. I would suggest wearing protection. Instead, it started burning. I was like, oh, it's pulling my skin off. I was like, I can't let go. It's pulling my skin off. I gotta hang on. Boom! I'm like, oh, my skin's gonna flip and land. And then I'm like, oh, I'm still in the air.
I'm so proud of you.
I just wanted to show you guys what glory looks like.
Dude, your stomach is horrible.
Yeah, it hurts, dude. Does anyone have any aloe vera? With my experience and your smart mouth, we're the best team to have on safety boat.
Totally.
The worst scenario you could get is a burned stomach from not having enough lube on the ramp.
Today they started selling six packs of awesome.
Shark Spawnafe is up next.
Wait. Shark Spawnafe.
Sorry. Shark Spawnafe is up next.
Shark Spawnafe. Professional wakeboarder who hit the zenith of his career at the tender age of 6 months when he became the youngest person on Earth to water ski. His career has gone downhill ever since.
Oh my God, he's floating, he's breathing. That was huge. That was Gigantosaurus. According to the speedometer. I did one and I was like, alright, not fair to do two.
Me too.
So I go into two and I come out of two. And I'm still like 25, 30 feet high, I felt like.
And you're like a half at that point.
And then I was just like, do I go three or do I just try to dive? And I tried to dive. That's why my wrist hurts.
That's what happens when 186 pounds of awesome hits the water at once.
It feels like I tore my uterus.
You're going third gear on this one, or second.
You're going third.
Third.
Just basically ejecting into the stratosphere?
Yeah.
Is that the plan?
Yeah.
If anybody can do it, it's you, Special Gregg, with your special powers, your special muscle. It's just fun working with a bunch of amazing athletes, you know? That's what it's all about.
I think at the heart of every single one of us, there's an athlete in there that just wants to smile and have fun every day, you know?
Well spoken, Gregg.
That's really what it's all about, I think.
What we need to get is Tommy has got to get his sissy, fat, doing nothing, white card, flag, pulling butt off of there.
Tommy,
Tell us what you really think.
Oh, yeah, I was holding back.
I've been talking to him. He is so terrified of this, and this is a layup.
If Tommy doesn't do this, I don't know what to say. Like, I don't know if he should be on the show anymore. I mean, I love Tommy as much as anybody, but you gotta do something at some point, right, Crumb?
Unfortunately, you're right.
He is the fat, funny guy.
Hilarious.
But we still need him to launch.
Get up there and get Tommy into a boner.
I'm gonna go pepper Tommy. I like to be talked into it. There's lots of times I don't want to do it, and people talk me into it, and I'm grateful.
Well, you're doing it for you, right, Tom?
But give it a firm grip. Get this ankle. Tommy, I cannot tell you how proud of you I am.
He's a big man, sir. Yeah.
Tommy, this is the thing, though, dude. You're scared, and you're going anyway. That's awesome. That's what it's about, buddy. That's what it's about.
This is why Street Fight Tommy is Street Fight Tommy.
Tommy, you're scared?
Stay loose, Tommy. Nice and relaxed. Confident.
Got it, Tommy. Hang on, buddy. Hang on. Make a lot of noise.
And I'm like, Tommy, I swear, I'll just roll on to second gear, just nice and easy. As soon as he got going, I was like, and he hit the pop. He got more pop than fun. Well, yeah, he had a lot of weight going up.
No.
Well, he had suspension, so everything compressed. It went, woo. It was like Kung Fu Panda. That was awesome. Tommy, I'm proud of you.
Our job is cool.
Right, thank you. And you go home today with that glow instead of going home and
look,
not trying.
I'm not saying, here's the thing. Yes, it is better than drywall. But let me tell you something. My job's good.
Your job is good, and you're good at it.
It's not just better than drywall. I mean, my job's good.
Yeah, I love it, Tommy. I love when you're this happy. Look at the moment. Look at the glorious moment right now.
I'm getting a little glazed over.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie. That was stressful.
Oh, you're gonna cry now. Oh, look at the big teddy bear. I love you.
I don't like water.
Yeah, I understand. Or heights, or speed.
It all scares me.
Good job, bud.
Yeah.
Let's go get that Kobe steak.
Yeah, let's do that.
And a girl.
Ah, it hurts so good. Oh, my God.
Oh, boy.
God has a mighty fist.
Yeah.
Woo!
Wow.
Now this.
Always properly lube.
Oh, God.
Oh, don't do that. Don't do that. It's so tender.
Street Bike Tommy. Legit. That dude is legit. Everybody knows when he launched the, you know, the bike over the foam pit.
No concussion? You feel everything?
Just willing to do anything not to work. Like, I don't want to have a job. I just want to, like, keep the party going for life.
He knows he's going to get hurt whenever he gets on, you know? It's like, gravity is not kind to Tommy.
You're like, dude, what else can this guy do?
You know, why is it when I show up to set and my name is on the roster, when I show up, you guys got something just completely out of hand, and you think just because you slapped a couple funny stickers on it, I'm going to be all pumped.
What happened to the phone call last night where I was like, Tommy, do you want to jump a boat? And you're like, hell yeah, I want to jump a boat.
Was it me?
It was you. I have a text as well.
That was some other fat guy using my phone.
Tommy, you're always talking about, as long as it's got horsepower in the stud, you're good.
Well, that's before I need to talk to the FAA for a boat airplane license.
Captain Awesome, let's turn up the heat and make this thing go.
This is your moment to shine. Let's do this.
Glad you're so psyched on it, Tommy. Let's go. Put this like in the water.
It is so windy. It's like worst conditions imaginable. We got white caps breaking over here. Tommy's getting in. I've never seen him so nervous. He has not talked at all today. We have a jump. Everyone, in my opinion, might be a little too close, but he is coming. I gotta go watch him.
Hey, this is the ramp setup for Vegas, so test it out, see if it works.
That looked painful.
How's your head, Special?
How's your legs?
I quit my job on a Friday afternoon.
We are here today to play Nitro Golf. This is a hole-in-one contest. He with the most flair, flying through the air, getting a hole-in-one, wins. Lands in!
I think I agree to this.
One, two, three, Nitro!
Nitro Golf round one. Four! Okay, not so bad on the first round there. That's a mulligan. I'm going again. Dusty's gonna get this.
I'm scared right now.
Get in there!
That's a hole in one.
Hole in one! See, this is so much fun.
It's your turn, Special. It's possible. Now give us some flair.
Just so you know, this could be really good or really bad. One more time.
So a few years back, I rolled 7 3/4 time in a rally race.
Travis's crash that he had in Colorado years ago was one of the biggest crashes actually caught on film in the world of rally.
I'm fine. How are you?
Holy, that was a hell of a ride.
Woo-hoo!
Today, Gregg Godfrey is going to take a crappy Mustang, driving this fast as it'll go, hitting this ramp, and seeing how many times he can roll the car. I can't wait to watch.
For Gregg to take that on, like, hey, I'm going to go take what you did and just try and beat you, is actually a really funny concept. I give him a lot of credit for the balls that it takes to actually go out and try and do that.
What do you think his odds are of getting your record? I see this possibly going good. And by good, I mean horribly bad. I'd hit the ramp at 110. I would
faster's
go,
better.
Faster's better.
Faster's better.
More speed. Can't go wrong with more speed.
No, you can't.
Who said that? What rule is that?
That's written. Look it up.
Yeah. It's in the rule of speed?
Yeah, look it up.
It's in the dictionary.
Oh! God, what is with you guys?
So right now, what we're doing is we're sitting on set waiting for Gregg Godfrey to have his balls drop somewhere from his throat to at least the mid part of his stomach to turn into ovaries.
And then eventually balls.
So he can actually hit this jump to try to beat my record, where I didn't even intentionally crash, and he's intentionally crashing. Oh, here we go. Wow, he is holding the nail.
This is such a bad idea.
What is he thinking? No. This has suddenly got way cooler.
Why is he doing this?
Now I know why he's taking so long.
That's good.
Oh, you gotta be crapping yourself, man, but that looks good. You're not gonna catch air. You're gonna tumble. It's gonna be good.
I'm good. I'm gonna go out and pull me in, and we'll go.
Gregg, you're gonna be good. This is gonna be a lot of. It's gonna be fun, man. Enjoy it.
Yeah, this is gonna be fun.
It's gonna be
for us.
I was gonna say it's gonna be a lot of fun for us. Yeah. When I said it's gonna be fun, that is not gonna be fun.
What kind of a friend are you?
It's gonna get whipped. It looks really fast. And it's really scary, and I would never, ever, ever intentionally flip at that speed.
Having said that, if he wants to win, he's going to have to go faster.
I'm sailing away. Set an open course for the virgin sea.
I love how scared Godfrey is.
He is totally out of his mind over this thing.
Because I've got to be free. Free to face the life that's ahead of me.
He's so nervous. I've never seen this out of him.
And I'll try, oh Lord, I'll try to
that was violent.
That is awesome! Are you alive?
Yeah, I'm not hurt.
Yeah! You got such good air at that last jump in. You came out that ramp so fast. And then you took off and it landed. We're like, oh,
did I just land on the roof?
No, it landed on the roof. I didn't think it was going to roll at first. Then it started rolling so fast and you were flying. Wow!
Godfrey, you are a nut. An absolute nut.
Why would you sign up for that?
Now you tell him.
No, I wouldn't have signed up for it.
Your shoulders hurting a little. Stand on that car.
Give us some cheers, guys.
Save it! Save it!
Oh, that was fun. Oh, I'm glad you're alive, dude.
Is that the battery?
Yeah, that's the battery.
As you can see, the battery's just toast. Just launched. Incredible. I'm speechless. I have no words to describe this.
That scared me.
Who does that? Who says, I'm going to try to roll a car as many times as I possibly can? What an idiot.
Did we get a count on the rolls yet?
To beat 7 3/4. The official count? 7! Not that I'm excited, but I kind of won. I mean, I lost, but I won, depending on which way you want to put that. Sorry, Gregg. Better luck next time, chap.
Well, Jam and Crumb, you have been specially chosen for this stunt. I'm lying. Nobody else wanted to do it. So it's up to you guys. Godspeed.
We're the last remaining stunt meet.
Fly straight.
All right, I got $5 at Jim. Jim will go up, stall, ditch it. Crown will go up, stall, ride it all the way down to a back flop, getting smoked.
I know, yeah. I don't think you're far off right there.
This part where it looks up.
1 second, Crumb, but you got all the things in place to go ahead and do this right the second time. Good luck.
Why do I not feel as confident as you, Travis?
Crumb. He's a part-time handyman. And he doesn't give it. He's got just enough talent to turn girls' heads, but not enough to seal the deal. He's hoping the live show will change that.
Nitro Circus history to bail out of something once you've started at it.
You're only as good as your last stunt.
It's actually my most disappointing day of my life was just now.
It's okay.
I'm disappointed in myself.
I know you are.
I let my friends down.
Yeah.
And I let myself down.
No, you didn't
down.
Let me down. You owe me $3.
Yeah, but...
But I was supposed to be here! That's the
captain! Grum, the good news is, you get to try this again. The bad news is, the rest of the crew has no faith in you. They're driving away right now. They just left you.
What?
Sometimes you get a second chance in life, and you gotta take it.
And your friends ain't there to watch you.
Who needs friends when you got a second chance? Trying to harness the Nitro cast before a show or a stunt is pretty much like trying to herd 1,000 clinically insane stray cats, except they all have skateboards and motorcycles, and they're all faster than me.
5 minutes! 5 minutes! Go out there! 5 minutes!
No, I got fans. Street bike Tommy. Best of the Nitro crew.
We've had to leave the country on many occasions to get the kind of footage that's going to make people flock to see this movie.
You know that there was no strings, there was no special effects, there was no green screen, there was no nothing to say that they didn't actually do it. And that's what you guys are doing. You're just actually doing it and saying, all right, watch.
We just arrived in Panama City, and we're going to start the day off with Jim trying to hydro skim across the Nitro City pool. In true Nitro fashion, it's going to be either really amazing or Jim's going to... I'm ready for either one.
I call anything over baby pool good.
you said that, right? Officially, that anything over the baby pool is me.
Yes.
If you and your bike make it over the baby pool,
yeah,
I don't
okay.
have to do this.
Clear.
Yes. I've never selfishly hoped that someone has made it as bad as I hope you make this. This is probably the gnarliest hydro skin I've ever actually seen. So, good luck. Please make it so I don't have to do it.
Yep.
Okay, so he's going to come from over there through the hotel and across the grass, and he's going to drop 8-10 inches onto the pool, and then he's going to jump the little pool, land on the grass, hopefully the bike's underneath him,
right.
And then over the rocks into the ocean and right away.
Right.
A back or neck cracker on this.
Yeah, whoever came up with that idea, Jim owes them 1,000 handshakes.
Well, apparently Travis is going to gear up right now, because that was technically a fumble.
I actually don't want Travis doing this.
I agree with you, but I think he can do it.
Yeah.
That's the thing. Like, I think Trav can skim through here and get a touchdown. If he does what Jim did, Trav's going to the hospital.
If Trav dittos what Jim did,
Yeah, plus Trav's head cannot. Yeah, he can't take it, and his shoulder will buckle.
Jim didn't make the touchdown. He didn't make the field goal. Unfortunately, he didn't even make the 2-point conversion on his last drive. He got the turnover, and now it's my turn. So he didn't have enough speed on a 450, and I'm gonna try it on a 250.
This is the part of the show where I crash and then Travis goes back. Oh, it's so easy. Does it no problem. I'm going to go have a beer. I'm not going to watch him.
Ronald McDonald's on his bike.
God, he looks stupid.
Why is he wearing a diaper?
I am nervous. He gets stung by a jellyfish right now, honestly.
You gotta give it to Jim, though. A, going first. B, on a bike that weighed twice as much as my bike weighed. And C, he didn't have all the goofy-looking hockey pads. He just freaking pinned it. And he's a durable son of a gun, because he landed flat on his face. And he's still alive. Thank you, Jim, again.
I think a lot of times, you just never expect the worst case scenario.
Hey, Tommy, ever since I've seen this stunt in an old spy movie, I've wanted a piece of it.
Where'd you get your instructions?
The internet.
Oh, we're totally safe.
They don't have fear. They just don't. They're scared of stuff, but in their minds, they only think about making it. They never think of what's going to happen if they don't. When it comes to something like flipping that car, what you guys are doing is mega sketchy.
Yeah, I know. If you guys land on your wheels, I'll go nuts. I don't think you're going to, though. Save.
We're the two dumbest people in this car right now. Two dumbest people in this car right now.
My heart's nervous for them!
I'm nervous right now.
Oh, here we go!
No! Oh, boy.
Moment of truth.
Don't come for free. Everything you want, gonna take it from me, yeah.
Stay still, buddy.
We need to cut him out of this car.
Let's bring him to the ground here, and we'll strap him in. We'll deal with something possibly with his neck, so we gotta be really gentle as possible, okay?
We're taking care of you, pal. You're gonna be all right.
Get me to the hospital.
You're all set.
We need to check you out. Nice work, everybody.
The difficult part for any athlete is that, you know, you have a crash. If you're scared of that stuff and you think about it,
when that deal happened out there with Jim, we were all scared, and everybody was worried about him.
He's hurt. You know, he's really hurt. He's in a situation that most of us could be in and dread.
Even when it does go wrong, these guys are mentally so strong.
You know, when it goes bad, it goes bad. There's nothing you can do about it. When you fall down, you got to get up and brush the dust off and go for it again. Can't quit.
Good morning, Panama. Yet another day of Nitro Circus, and we are gap jumping tricycles and bikes over 400 foot buildings.
I just remember the last shoot that we did when the big wheels fell apart, and the first guy that went down, the tire fell off, the second guy that went down, the handlebars actually went all the way down, then Dusty went down, and the bicycle went down, and then we had a flat tire.
We've come a long way since then.
Yeah, that was 5 days ago. Oh, yeah. This is so scary.
better idea on paper.
Everyone's a little worried about safety. Jeremy and I decided we'd check and see what the worst case scenario might look like, just to put everyone's mind at ease.
Bombs away!
And launcher.
Oh God.
Holy.
Oh my God.
Seems perfectly safe if anything goes wrong.
Why is it everything that we do that's deadly also has to be sketchy? You think if it's deadly, it would be a perfect setup, but it's not. It's always stupid.
All right, Spez. Film LB. We all concur that he's so scared of not making the gap, which, oh, granted, that's death, that he's going to go too far, in which case that's just a broken back. So he's getting a push by Special Greg. It's a long way down.
I hope they make it.
All right, Eric. 3, 2, 1.
I'd rather see me land than you land. So we're Rochambeau for who gets the privilege.
All right, we'll just jump in and meet me over here. We'll have a cocktail later.
All right.
Good luck. See, that's what you call reverse psychology. I definitely did not want to flip. I'm scared. Let's even trying to jump. That worked. That worked great. Couldn't have asked for anything better. Thanks, Greg.
So the plan is to go twice as high and twice as far. Is that the plan?
That'll do better for you.
That'll work, right? All right. Love you guys.
Love you, pal.
All right, light it up.
I am covered head to toe.
You look like a homemade action figure.
Accidentally went too far and almost got all the way to the boxes. So, Jim, let's get all the way to the boxes, man. Give me a push. Man, right, I mean
smart.
A push.
All right. Well, I can tell Travis is nervous. Because whenever he gets nervous, he's like, and I just hear him chirping up there like a bird.
You got him, Jim?
No, I got a nice little spot right here.
Well,
ready?
Good push.
1, 2, 3.
That was shit.
Maybe if you weren't wearing 80 pounds in pads, I could push you.
Actually, that's probably a good point. I didn't think it was going to be... Actually, I knew it was going to be that scary. I was just fooling myself, thinking that maybe it wouldn't get done. But be careful what you ask for, because Nitro Circus will give you the opportunity to do it.
We're dream makers. What can I tell you?
Making dreams and nightmares come true.
Mostly nightmares. Ready or not, here we come, Vegas.
It is one thing to watch it on television, but live and in person, it is like seeing a UFO. You can never fully appreciate it until you see it live.
We're a couple of minutes from showtime, and I've never been so nervous in all my life.
No idea what the hell I was even showing up to. I just walked in the arena and it was packed.
1 minute! 1 minute!
The Nitro Circus is like art. What all these guys are doing now, people aren't going to be doing in the future.
You guys keep getting doors slammed in your face.
because everyone feels like someone's gonna die doing these stunts.
The fact that so many people did say no makes me believe even more strongly that this is a great idea.
It's been a long road coming here. Let's prove to the world that we can do this.
We have 10 seconds to stop.
1, 2, 3, fire!
People always said that Nitro Circus couldn't work as a live show, but with this much passion, it was always gonna work.